Lenovo P620s and the Threadripper PROs had a transformational effect on our delivery of Jedi Survivor. Every element of our development got faster. We couldn't have done it without it.
Respawn is a game development company founded over 10 years ago, devoted to creating quality AAA video game experiences from Titanfall to Apex Legends to, of course, my team, which works on Star Wars Jedi franchise.
After releasing Jedi Fallen Order, we knew we wanted to do more and kind of push the envelope into many directions that we weren't able to do for the first go-around.
We have a huge number of speaking narrative characters in this game, and that means they have facial animations, they have gestures, they have idle animations. We also have a giant combat cast as well.
We wanted to double down on giving the players more choices on how they play the game.
Everything is bigger. The environments and the vistas are bigger. It's allowing us to give a richer experience to everybody.
COVID struck very near the beginning of this project's life cycle. So we were going remote, and that creates all kinds of issues.
A lot of that was around productivity. Things that we'd just taken for granted because we're all in one building together just ceased functioning straight away.
Bandwidth, VPN access, the fact that builds are usually distributed on the LAN and suddenly you're on someone's home internet connection. So in the end, we decided to put the Lenovo P620s along with the AMD Threadripper PROs onto the desks of all of our developers, from programmers to designers to artists, which benefit all of us in different ways throughout the project.
Just having a beast of a machine at home with a large number of cores really helps us compensate for that internet connection just not being where it needs to be for working remotely.
One of the concepts behind Respawn as a company is kind of finding the fun, the idea of gameplay that feels good.
We'll have a goal in mind or an idea that we want to try out, and we take some of those ideas and we run forward with them as quickly as we can to prove them out.
The faster that we can iterate and get that in the hands of our dev team, the better quality we get to, and ultimately that's the better game for the players.
We're running in Unreal 4, which was the same engine from Jedi Fallen Order, heavily modified to support our project and all of its varied needs.
There are some key technologies in Unreal Engine that we're exploiting, and one of those is the HLOD system. One of our levels was creeping up to 12, 13 hours to build that HLOD data. And similarly, for min-spec PCs that don't have ray tracing, we need to bake in the lighting. That was taking 3 days for one section of the game. By employing the Threadrippers, we've made that a third.
We found that our build time for cooked and packaged builds went from 12 to 15 hours down to 4 to 5 hours per build. A wasted day is massive for a team of our size, whereas if you're cooking every 4 hours, you have a lot of shots during the day to get a great build that is good for the team the next day.
There were many reasons for choosing AMD as a partner. One of those key reasons was that AMD is the chipset in the Gen 5 consoles. Respawn is launching Jedi on those Gen 5 consoles and PC.
The boon to development that the AMD Threadripper PRO had for us honestly can't be overstated. It's very empowering to our team and the whole entire project, and that uplift can be felt across the entire development cycle.
The fact that the team's managed to deliver a high quality game in COVID world is a phenomenal achievement. Once you've experienced 32 or 64 cores, there's no going back. It really isn't. People would leave the company if we took those away from them now.